Now, the book, you mentioned 2041, and you talk about things that you believe, you say in the book, have an 80% chance likelihood of coming to pass just in the next 20 years. Talk a little bit about where you think artificial intelligence is in that time and how it affects human beings, how it affects society, both individually and broadly.
So in 20 years, it will disrupt every industry. Just as it has disrupted and enabled the internet industry, it will do the same to the financial industry, essentially doing a much better job than most people in the investment, insurance, or banking industries. And it will change the future of healthcare, inventing and helping scientists invent new drugs at 1/10 the time and price, helping us to live healthier and longer. It will change the future of education, allowing each child to have an AI companion teacher that teaches exactly in a way that helps the child get better in an interest alignment. And this goes on for every possible industry. Transportation, there will be autonomous vehicles. We'll stop buying cars. Cars will be Uber that comes to us exactly when we need it, in the size and shape we need it, and it will be 90% safer than it is today. So I think all of these disruptions will happen, but it will also have significant implications on the environment and society. It will take away a large number of jobs and create many more jobs, but there are different jobs. It will cause tension between the large companies that have the data and the people who are sometimes helpless against it. It will widen the gap of inequality between the haves and have-nots, increasing wealth inequality between people and between companies and between countries.
Of course, we can see that there will be certain tactical skills that will still be relevant, empathy, which clearly AI doesn't have an edge on or a capacity for. And what I hear you saying in all sorts of fields that right now are confined mostly to the internet, but soon will be in education and will be in health and will be in accounting and law and finance and driving and all of this, is that, you know, if for those that have skill sets that are comparatively easily replicated, those jobs are gone. Is that right?
That's right. I would call them routine jobs. Any job that where the tasks you do can be require no more than 5 seconds of thought, that's a very dangerous sign. Any job where the work that you do is repetitive or routine, that's a dangerous sign. The one caveat is routine jobs that require a human-to-human connection. So let's say a elderly care, I would argue that will stay, because even if a robot could wash and shower an elderly person, the elderly person isn't going to want a robot to do that, and certainly not going to want a robot to be a companion and talk to. So I still think many service-oriented connect human connection-oriented jobs will remain, even though they're routine.
Now, the dystopian version of that is that a lot of jobs that capitalists would describe as routine, people that receive that service would actually describe as having an interaction. I mean, if I go into McDonald's and talk to a waiter or a waitress or my local restaurant, not an expensive one, but you still have human interaction. Go into a taxi and you're picked up from JFK. Senior citizens would much rather have engagement with a human being to be taken care of, but that sounds expensive. You know, if I take both the AI improvements that are coming that you are describing, and this is not 50, 100 years out, this is most people watching the show are gonna see this, they're gonna experience this, God willing, and then combine that with the sort of growth of inequality that we would expect to see, that implies that an awful lot of human engagement that most of us presently benefit from will have less of it. Isn't that right?
I hope not. And here's the reasoning. People will have a hard time getting routine jobs, so there will be many people displaced looking for new things to do. Yet they won't be skilled to do complex projects and new skills. These are going to be 50-year-olds who have been doing routine jobs all their lives. They can't just suddenly become an AI programmer or become a brain surgeon, right? So the one big category of job that they will be able to be retrained to do are the service jobs. And those are jobs that we don't want robots to do. So that will be one force that will push forward the human-human connection. And then to the extent these people can do a good job, more people will pay more money for it. And in fact, I think the wealthy people will have even more money. And so they're more willing to spend and many goods will become commoditized. So I think more wealthy people will want to spend the money on services, not products. Maybe a concierge planned vacation to Europe, or a bartender who mixes fancy drinks, or someone who comes to your home and makes your closets beautiful. These are, I think, services that people will pay for, and new professions may get created to provide those services.